Howdy Droogs, Kel here again. Well, I've got an order in here from PipesandCigars.com. I ordered this about a week ago. I decided to find one to try Lane Limited DCA, and they had it in stock for the first time in a long time. So I thought what I'd do is go through this box. I made an order of over $100 and ordered some other stuff so I could get the BCA. And guess what? They didn't have the BCA in stock after all. So I'll just go through this box and see what I did get. Little flyer about cigars and stuff. We don't need that. First up, some Lane Limited Very Cherry. Take a look at this stuff here. Very Cherry. It says a rich mixture of traditional Burleys, bright Virginias, and toasted Cavendish, laced with a unique Very Cherry flavor for a smooth, aromatic smoking experience. I love Lane Limited tobacco. It's reasonable. In fact, it's downright cheap for the price you pay. And if you buy 4 ounces or more, you get a better price break. Take a sniff of that, guys. That is Very Cherry smelling, almost chemically. I'm not sure how that's going to be. I ordered this because I used to get something called Very Cherry from my local, and I kind of wanted to get that again. I'm not sure which brand is they used to carry. They carry a different one now, I think. But anyway, that should be interesting. I've got some Stoker Beast Very Cherry. I'm not real fond of. This might be better. I like Lane Limited stuff. Anyway, so what they are doing, though, they're going to send me the BCA set in a separate package, and they're not charging me for shipping an easy package, which is nice. Next up, got some RLP6. I actually have some of this already, but I'm kind of running low, so I figure I better reorder here. This is good smelling stuff. It's kind of nice. This is the Lane Limited's version of Captain Black. It's nicer than Captain Black, in my opinion, though. It's just a little more refined tasting. I always felt Captain Black tasted a little bit dirty to me, I don't know. Anyway, see this is back on my thing here. You're seeing that because I made this video once already, but guess what? Didn't turn the camera on. Talk to a dead camera for 10 minutes. How dumb am I anyway, huh? Okay, Balkan Supreme is up next. This was a tobacco originally introduced to me by Northwest Pipe Smoker, Tom. Tom, thank you very much. He sent me some, and I've been smoking it since. I like this stuff. Let's see how this smells. Ugh, smells like crap. Take a whiff of that. It's very dark. Black Malachi in there. I'm not sure it makes a Balkan or not. I used to know, but I looked it up at one time, but I've forgotten. But Tom really likes stuff, and I must say I do too. I find the worse something smells in the way of an English, the better it tastes. And this smells nasty, so it tastes real good. The Creek is nice. It's just a nice tobacco. Lane Limited TK6. Take a look at this little tobacco here where we're at. TK6. Toasted Cavendish again forms the mellow flavor of this blend, but now a blend of Burleys adds a robust zing and a hint of cherry, just the right sweetness. Let's smell this and see what this is like. This is very nice, dark Cavendish. I like Cavendish tobacco anyway. That nice, take a look at that, guys. Take a big smell of that. Isn't that nice? Yeah, that's nice. Let me go out and smoke some of this on the deck. Actually, since I didn't get my BCA, and I've actually been really more interested in this now, actually. This should be interesting. That can be my go-to tobacco. There's another one that's kind of interesting that you might find interesting. This is, get it out here. Oops, I guess. This is Gwaithan Hogarth Sweet Coconut Twist. This is bulk tobacco again. This is an old robe-style tobacco flavored with the island scent of coconut. And take a look at it. If you found that on the floor of your house and you owned a dog, you'd be probably chiding him and burn for doing that, wouldn't you? Seems a bit dry. Let's take a smell of that. I don't find this to smell real good. One of my ex-girlfriend's ex-wife used to, when we were young, used to wear coconut suntan oil. We'd go down by the river and hang out and do things. Well, I'll tell you. I used to love summertime. The smell of that coconut oil on her skin was so nice. To this day, coconut oil, you know, kind of has fond memories for me. I've been looking forward to this for a long time. And again, another tobacco they were almost always out of, so I'm really looking forward to trying that in my twist pipe. I've got a pipe I use just for twists. And I got some tins of tobacco as well. Here's some McClellan's Captain Cool, another Captain Black. Kind of a Captain Black copy in a sense, only this is much nicer, a little cooler. Let's see if we can, I know my computer's doing weird crap now, so, oh, god damn it anyway. It's stupid. Okay. Well, I've hit a button on my computer, and now my computer won't do what I need to do. Jeez Louise. Good God, come on. Okay, full screen. Okay. Sorry, guys. I'm a mess today. Okay, this is McClellan's. It says, this is a cool-smoking, mild pipe tobacco that will not bite the tongue. Lightly fragrant, always appealing. Take a look inside. Again, you can see it looks a bit like Captain Black. This has kind of a mint smell to it a little bit. Take a whiff of that, guys. Kind of a little mint smell to it, which is kind of interesting, kind of nice. A lot of black, whatever that is, Cavendish or whatever in there, I guess. This is nice tobacco. It's expensive, though. $8.15. If you buy five or more, they're $7.27. That's not really a good deal in tobacco, in my opinion. But it's one of their special lines, so it's kind of expensive. But it is good stuff. And there's not a ton in there. It's not like it's actually packed in there, tied or anything. I mean, but it's good stuff. If you like Captain Black, you might want to try that. It is nice. Nice alternative. It won't bite you either. What else? Well, here we go. Here's some Sunset Breeze. Again, I have some of this, but I always want to have this on hand because it's a nice tobacco. This is an aromatic flavored tobacco. Let's look up this up for the fun of it. Peterson Sunset Breeze. This excellent mixture is a blend of First Choice Virginia Burley and Black Cavendish, a promise for unique smoking experience, which is crowned by a wonderful amaretto aroma that also gives enjoyment for those around you. This is an interesting tobacco, and I do recommend you do try this. I did a video on this before. Beautiful tin. I collect tins, and it's beautiful tins, so that's also nice. But I want to open this because I'm just going to sell this for a while because I've got another one. I've got some of this left in a baggie, and I just wouldn't have some on hand. Here's an interesting tobacco club blend. Again, I've got some of this, but I thought I'd just get some more on hand. I previously opened this in the other video, so I thought I'd open it here and show it to you. If you've never seen club blend, again, nice tin. And Mac Baron is nice in this way, I find very nice in the sense that Mac Baron doesn't chintz out on how much pet tobacco they give you. This is a 3.5 ounce tin. It's 11.17. That's not too bad, 11.17 a pipe for cigars. Let's pull something, take a look at it here. This is a paper thing. As you can see, it's a spun and cut tobacco, which ends up being little discs. Isn't that interesting? I like this stuff. It has a really interesting smell. A little raisiny, I don't know. Little black things in the middle are Black Cavendish. These little black spots in the middle are like little Black Cavendish. You see those? They say you're supposed to rub this all out, and the last stuff I got is I did rub all out. But I decided I wanted to have some just like, in discs. I like just kind of crunching up like this and putting them in my pipe. Crunching several of them, just putting them in my pipe like this, is nice rather than rubbing them. You see it falls apart pretty good though. But I like just having, and sometimes I'll take these things. I've got a big-ass pipe, one of my older pipes, and I'll just stack them. I'll just actually put them in my pipe like this and just stack them in there like that. Like that. Just put them in, And then just light them that way. That's kind of a cool thing to do with these as well. That's really kind of fun. Just make a little stack of them and just tie your pipe and away you go. Can you see that? That's kind of fun. This is nice stuff. It's body like all Mac Baron, but if you age it for a while, I don't think it's quite so bad. But, smoke it easy and slow, and it'll reduce the bite a little bit. I'm going to make a video about tongue bite one of these days. So a series of videos. But anyway, there that is. I'm tempted to go smoke some of that right now. I've been kind of craving some of this, and I've been kind of craving some of this, that isn't rubbed out at all. Mine is rubbed out. I've got put away right now. I'll just put this in a jar, and that'll be the end of that. And I've got some Celtic Talisman, Samuel Gwaith. I've wanted some of this for a long time, and I opened this up again on the other video that didn't actually be a video. This is interesting stuff. This is, I'll read this to you. This is what this says about this. Celtic Talisman. Celtic Talisman is a blend from Wright Virginia's Burley and Black Cavendish, topped with a dash of a sweet cherry. This blend redefines the aromatic. I'm not smelling the cherry in there. It does smell a little raisiny. This stuff's not pretty cheap. This stuff is only $14. They have it on sale for $11. It's not real cheap. But when they pack it in these tins like this, you'll be amazed how much tobacco is in it. This says it's 50 grams. And you'd be amazed how much actually is in here. Once you take this out and put it into a jar, it's actually quite a bit. And they do pack it nice and tight, which is nice. Here, take a smell of that. See what you think, guys. See it getting through there on the camera? I know, that joke gets old. Anyway, there you go, Southern Calisthenics, nice little tin. I'll keep the tin when I'm done with it. They collect the tins! They sent me some matches, which I'll never use. Maybe I'll give away to somebody or a friend or something, or I'll just have them in reserve. I might use these if I don't, anyway, enough of that. based on the catalog, which is an interesting runway, and that is you'll notice this is upside down on this side. That's because when you go through the pipes and cigar, the cigar side of it, this is all cigars here. When you get to the pipe side of it, then it's upside down. So you've got to turn it around to look at the pipes. See, that's the cigars are that way there. I just thought it was interesting, you know. Then when you get to the pipes, you really got to turn it upside down like this and go from this side to look at the pipes. An interesting, kind of fun idea for a catalog. And here's all the pipes and crackles and stuff in there and all the good stuff. So that's it. There's BCA right there. BCA, fire-cured cannabis tobacco with just sweetly flavored to produce an extremely mild, still-burning, cool smoke. See how black the BCA is? I really want some of that stuff. It's going to be here tomorrow. And I'll probably do a box opening video on that too, and I certainly will smoke it. All right, guys, that's it. This is the second try for this video. Hopefully, you know, next time hopefully this one took. All right, guys, we'll talk to you later. Remember, keep enjoying your pipes, enjoying your life, because that's what it's all about. I'll talk to you later.